على الآيات والذكر وفي فيض من العطر هنا رمضان مدرسة تنير مآثر الفكر على الآيات والذكر وفي فيض من العطر هنا رمضان.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in Surah Al-Isra, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the Quran as being a book that guides to that which is the best, al-aqwam. And the word aqwam can refer to either the best in terms of justice-wise, in terms of the information it presents. It can also be translated as the most valuable, because what the Quran offers the human being is extremely valuable. You cannot find it elsewhere. It can provide us with information, with a perspective to life that you just simply cannot find elsewhere. It is the straight path, as-sirat al-mustaqim, and as we all know, the shortest distance between two points is a straight line, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does that for us in a very concise manner. What we tend to focus on as a community are the social and the political aspects of the Qur'an, the political justice, the social justice that it has to offer to offer humanity. What we tend to overlook or not emphasize nearly as much as we should is the theological justice, the theological value that the Qur'an has to offer. And that is, the Qur'an is a book that revolves, that rotates, that's centered around La ilaha illallah, that there's nothing worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that we have a direct individual without any intermediaries, a type of relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is so beautiful. The more you study it, the more you engage it, the more valuable you see it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based this theology, based this tawheed on submission to Him. What we gain, the most precious gem of the Quran, is that He tells us to submit to Him. And that was the attribute, the main attribute shared by all prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Ibrahim alayhi salam as someone who submitted to him. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to submit, he said, I submit to the Lord of the worlds without condition, because Ibrahim alayhi salam understood that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best being that a person can become close to, can relate to, can become dependent on, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To present three valuable pieces of theology the Quran has to offer us, number one is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tawheed, la ilaha illallah, that there's nothing worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more we love Him, the more we see Him as praiseworthy, the more we submit ourselves to Him. What better can you provide yourself? What better can you give your children than to remind yourself and to remind them that you have a God who every night during the last third of the night calls out to you as an individual and to all of mankind, saying, who wants to ask for forgiveness? Who needs forgiveness that I forgive them? Who has a dua for me to answer? Who has a request for me to fulfill? When you acknowledge that, you find out that you are constantly taken care of. Another valuable piece of information the Quran has to offer you is the afterlife. So in the second verse which I recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. One of the styles of the Quran is that He describes people not with nouns but with adjectives or a description, saying that those who reject Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have created a barrier between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by disbelieving in the next life. In other words, because they disbelieve in the next life, they disbelieve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we as Muslims are able to engage Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a manner that is unique, because we believe that we will return to Him and that there is plenty of reward that He is preparing for us, for those who submit to Him. And finally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offers us something that is very relevant and very needed in our times, and that is purpose. We were created for a reason. To give a very simple analogy, if I were to take a pen and put it on the floor and say I did that for absolutely no reason, there must be a reason why I did that. We cannot accept that I did that for no reason. then can we accept that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created an entire universe, a structured universe, a marvelous universe for absolutely no reason? Purpose. When we feel that we have purpose, we know our identity. We are able to live this life with a vision. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us acknowledge, to help us internalize the value, the theological value the Quran has to offer us. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.